Let me know when everybody is good. You ready? Everybody's good? All right, fantastic. Well, thank you for being here this afternoon. I want to first welcome Senator Geraldine Thompson. Thank you for joining me again this afternoon. We will hear from the Senator in a moment. In March of this year, Tyrese Sampson, a 14-year-old boy visiting Florida from Missouri, fell to his death from the Eagle Drop Tower in Orlando. With the magnitude of this incident, it was important to me that the department take the necessary time to conduct a thorough investigation and get this right, which I believe that we have done to the best of our ability. The department's investigation has concluded that Tyree fell from the drop tower due to the changes made by the ride by the operators. He was sitting in one of two seats where the proximity sensor was manually repositioned to allow a larger restraint opening other than the ride's other seats. Because his seat's harness proximity sensor had been improperly adjusted, the ride was allowed to commence even though the ride was unsafe and led directly to his fall. The department's investigation also revealed there was minimal training conducted on the ride. A training manual did not exist. Neither of the attendants nor the operator had read or seen the manufacturer manual, nor had an operating document been provided to the attendants or the operators that were on duty. And all the attendants and the operator confirmed that they had been instructed that seats 1 and 2 were being used for larger guests. Today, my department issued an administrative complaint alleging multiple violations of Florida law related to these findings. We are seeking an administrative fine exceeding $250,000, one of the largest administrative fines the department has ever sought, and a permanent revocation of the ride's operating permit in the state of Florida. The details of the allegations are outlined in the administrative complaint and investigative report, which will be available through the link in the press release to follow. I've instructed my staff to forward our findings to the Orange County Sheriff's Department to consider criminal charges. From the beginning, I've promised that my office would seek legislative remedies based on our findings. And back in July, we held a press conference on our initial framework for potential legislation. Since then, we've expanded and refined that framework into a list of proposed legislative objectives to help prevent the kind of tragedy that happened to Tyree from never happening again. Our goal here is to identify the issues that we believed played a direct part in his death. These objectives will also be available through the link in the press release to follow. First, as I mentioned back in July, we'd like to expand the signage posting requirements for patron qualifications. Currently, the law only mandates signage required by the manufacturer. Our changes would mandate the postings of all patron requirements, warnings, and/or exclusions included in the ride manual. Second, we want to see an increased number of safety system checks during the permitting process before engineers sign off on the FDAC's annual affidavits. Third, update the term major modifications to include any modifications of safety settings. Fourth, we want to add department authority to adopt rules for employee training and create a minimal standard for operating, training, retaining, and training program documentation. Fifth, clarify department authority and increase reporting requirements for the documentation of maintenance and the required reporting of any changes made to safety systems and restraints. Sixth, add authority to require all administrative devices to undergo ride commissioning and certification as part of the permitting requirements. This will provide a certification that the ride was manufactured, assembled, tested, and put into service following all manufacturing qualifications and specifications. Seventh, add a requirement that the operator must provide the department with location and other data from the manufacturer of all tolerance, settings, and specifications related to the patron restraints and safety systems. Eighth, increase the required accident reporting for amusement rides. And finally, we want to request new positions with the sole mission of inspecting permanent ride facilities and traveling shows and fairs to monitor safe operations and verify training of on-site staff during the operation. Safety monitors will perform unannounced visits to observe and ensure operations to being conducted following proper procedures, verify proper training of all on-duty employees, and observe the ride in operation to detect unsafe ride conditions that may have occurred following the last of the inspections. We are so lucky that Senator Geraldine Thompson is committed to caring and fighting for this legislation and hope that Commissioner-elect Wilton Simpson and the new legislature will also make this a top priority for 2023. Thank you so much for your support and dedication to this issue, Senator. I turn the floor over to you.
Thank you all for joining us this afternoon. I'd like you to think about your expectations when you get into your vehicle on a daily basis. You expect that the brakes are going to work. You expect that the airbag is operable. You expect that the seatbelt works. Now, contrast that with a ride that takes you 400 feet into the air and you have a harness that goes over the body that doesn't lock in properly because it's been adjusted. And when the millions of people who visit Florida come to this state, we want them to know that there is oversight, that there is accountability, that there are inspections, that there are requirements for training, all of the things that Commissioner Freed just talked about. And so the very first bill that I'm going to file as a member of the Florida Senate will be the Tyree Sampson Law. We had a 14-year-old young man with a promising future. He was a 4.0 in terms of his GPA. He was a five-star athlete, and he fell out of this ride because things were adjusted that were contrary to the directions of the manufacturers. So the Tyree Sampson Law is going to address all of those things. You've already heard that signage is something that has to be addressed. Any modification will trigger another inspection. We'll look at the frequency of inspections and have unannounced visits to these amusement rides to make sure that they are following the laws of the state of Florida. The fine that has been imposed is a very significant fine and will put on notice other people, other entities that operate amusement rides, that there are consequences to not following the laws here in the state of Florida. And so I am committed to filing this legislation, and it is not a partisan issue. That's something I really want to stress. It is a safety issue. It's about the welfare and the safety and the life of people who come to this state, and we know that tourism is the backbone of our economy here in the state of Florida. And we also want to say to the family of Tyree Sampson that if we could, we would undo what happened to their son, but we can't. But what we can do is to make sure that our laws will prevent this from happening to anyone else. And the fact that the bill will be the Tyree Sampson Law will mean that his life will not have been in vain, that it will mean that we're now going to have everyone know who he was, what his contributions were, and to recognize those contributions with the Tyree Sampson Law. So thank you all for joining us.
Thank you so much, Senator. You know, Senator Thompson was right there every step along the way, making sure that exactly this, that a young boy's loss of his life was not going to go in vain, that an investigation was going to be conducted thoroughly. And now, based on what we have gone through, it has been a terrific partnership. And again, and hoping that Commissioner-elect Wilton Simpson and will carry this new legislation and will make this a priority. This again is not a Republican or a Democratic issue. This is a safety issue. And as leaders, we have a responsibility to do everything in our power to ensure that these rides are safe as possible. So with that, we'll go ahead and take questions. Yeah, so what we did, it was a kind of in conjunction again. So we have experts that are inside the Department of Agriculture that are involved in the ride inspections to the safety manual protocols. And so as we went through our investigation, we saw some of the things that we've been openly talking about. You know, some of the issues are across the board that we are being asked about, and we wanted to make sure that we came to the right conclusion. So as we kind of went through this, had consultation with the senator's office, with our experts, and this is the recommendations that are coming from our people that are on the ground of what are some things that we can move forward on to make things more safe.
What is the first thing y'all are expecting following this, announcement?
Well, the next thing is that hopefully legislation will be submitted, and it's on the senator's timeline at this point of when to submit it. But obviously today our complaint has been submitted, and so now we'll go through the formal process of levying that fine and moving forward. And of course, with that, we are submitting, as I stated earlier, all of those documentations of our investigative reports and complaints will go over to the Orange County Sheriff's Office for further criminal investigation.
We're also expecting that the free fall ride will be dismantled and removed from the location at Icon Park. Icon Park leases space for the free fall ride. They don't operate the ride. And the decision was made not to take the ride down until the investigation was complete. And now that the investigation has been complete, we expect to see that ride removed.
Based on what you've seen, do you think it rises to the level of criminal charges?
While I am an attorney and was a public defender, it is definitely not going to be within my purview to have the Orange County, you know, what they come out with. There is definitely, there was intent to change the sensors on there. Whether it rises to criminal intent will be up to the discretion of not only the sheriff's office, but the ultimate prosecutors of that county if they so choose to bring criminal charges. All right. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator.
Mm-hmm.